Well, that situation renews the call for a public safety auditor.
Right now, the city of Omaha, a step closer to bringing back the position. KETV NewsWatch 7's Todd Andrews is live with a story you're seeing only on 7.
Brandy, the last time the city had a public safety auditor was back in 2006, but now the city law department has drawn up an ordinance that would create the job of independent public safety auditor, and if the council approves it, it'll put it to a vote of the people next year. We got a hold of a copy of that draft ordinance.
Omaha's police and fire departments have gone without independent oversight since 2006, when the public safety auditor was fired by then-Mayor Mike Fahey. Now,
I would like to get it on the agenda very soon.
The city is a step closer to seeing the auditor's office occupied again.
What I'm looking for more than anything else is protection for whoever's in that position, financially, as well as making sure that they can be independent and say what needs to be said.
Councilman Ben Gray refers to this, a draft ordinance written up by the city legal department at his request. As written, Gray's ordinance calls for a, quote, independent public safety auditor position. It would be paid for out of the city's general fund. In order for all that to happen, though, the city charter would have to be amended, something the ordinance would also do.
And the ordinance also calls for the auditor position to be put to a vote of the people in next year's primary.
Of course, the council would have to approve the plan before it would go to the people. Initial reactions from Gray's colleagues indicate openness to his idea.
It makes sense that if we are going to have a police auditor, you know, that there should be a source of funding. So, I mean, it's certainly something to talk about.
I can certainly understand Mr. Gray's position.
Former public safety auditor Tristan Bond says she's happy to see the city moving another step closer to increased accountability.
We have so much work that we have to get done to get back to a level of trust between the community and many of these agencies.
Councilman Gray says the public safety auditor ordinance will likely show up on a council agenda next month, so there could be a vote on it next month. There's no word on how much money would be needed, though, to fund the position. Reporting in the Newsplex, Todd Andrews, KETV NewsWatch 7.
Thanks, Todd.